Dedicated dog lovers tend to be very kind people. We share our hearts and homes, and for some lucky pups, even the foot of our beds, with our canine pals. Surely there is nothing wrong with sharing our favorite foods with them too, right? Not necessarily. Many of the foods, such as fruits and vegetables, that humans digest just fine can wreak havoc on a dog's body, causing severe health problems. On the other hand, some of the foods people eat can be introduced to a dog's diet just fine, and even provide health benefits such as joint strength, better breath, and allergy immunity. But before giving your dog foods that you crave, read on and learn which foods are safe, and which can send your dog straight to the emergency vet. And always be mindful that even healthy foods fed in excess can lead to canine obesity, a major health concern for US dogs. Human foods dogs can eat. Carrots. Carrots are a great veggie choice for two main reasons. First, uncooked carrots are crunchy. When your dog bites into a piece of carrot, the carrot naturally acts as a toothbrush and helps remove tartar off your pup's teeth. Just be careful. Carrots can be a choking hazard, so if you have a small puppy or a dog who is susceptible to swallowing large items, you may want to make sure you chop them up into swallowable bites. Second, carrots are also packed with antioxidants which can help improve eyesight and boost your dog's immune system. To incorporate in your dog's food, chop up one full carrot and mix it into your dog's dinner. Green beans. Is your dog a little chunky, but always begging for more food? If so, green beans might be the perfect vegetable option to incorporate into your pup's diet. Green beans are a very low-calorie veggie. This means you can bulk up your dog's food bowl without having your pup pack on the pounds. In fact, some vets instruct owners of obese dogs to replace a portion of their dog's kibble with green beans to help them lose weight without losing nutrition. Green beans are also high in fiber, which is great for digestion, and are packed with healthy omega-3s which support heart health. For a medium-sized dog, add about a half a cup of cooked or raw green beans to your dog's food. Adjust as necessary according to the size of your dog. Some might consider broccoli a super veggie because it contains all sorts of vital nutrients. For a medium-sized dog, add about a half a cup of cooked or raw green beans to your dog's food. Adjust as necessary according to the size of your dog. Sweet potato. Sweet potatoes are an excellent source of iron, calcium, selenium, B vitamins, and vitamin C. The best part, dogs love them. It's safe for your dog to eat sweet potatoes raw, but they are sweeter, tastier, and less of a choking hazard after they've been boiled or baked. Aside from topping your pup's food with sweet potato, it's really nice to cut the potato into strips, bake the strips, and use the strips as a dog treat. Broccoli. Some might consider broccoli a super veggie because it contains all sorts of vital nutrients, including iron, calcium, selenium, B vitamins, and vitamin C. And not only are those vitamins and minerals good for humans, they're also essential to your pup's well-being. On top of nutritional benefits, the stocky texture of uncooked broccoli also makes a great toothbrush for your dog. While broccoli is a safe choice for your pup, be sure to limit the quantity to around 5% of your dog's total food. The reason, broccoli can make your dog bloated, gassy, and uncomfortable if it's consumed in a large quantity. You have been warned. Pumpkin. If your dog suffers from either constipation or diarrhea, pumpkin just might be the solution for your pup's problems. Pumpkin is incredibly high in fiber, which helps regulate the digestive system. It's also very tasty to most dogs, so if you're having a hard time getting your dog to eat, a few scoops of pumpkin might be helpful. You can safely replace up to a quarter of your dog's food with pumpkin puree. Just make sure you're buying plain canned pumpkin at the store and not pumpkin pie filling. Cheese, yes, dogs can eat cheese in small to moderate quantities. As long as your dog isn't lactose intolerant, which is rare, but still possible in canines, cheese can be a great treat. Many kinds of cheese can be high in fat, so go for lower fat varieties like cottage cheese or mozzarella. Corn, yes, dogs can eat corn. Corn is one of the most common ingredients in most dog foods. However, the cob can be hard for a dog to digest and may cause an intestinal blockage, so if you're sharing some corn, make sure it is off the cob. Coconut, yes, coconut is okay for dogs. This funky fruit contains lauric acid, which can help combat bacteria and viruses. It can also help with bad breath and clearing up skin conditions like hot spots, flea allergies, and itchy skin. Coconut milk and coconut oil are safe for dogs too. Just be sure your dog doesn't get its paws on the furry outside of the shell, which can get lodged in the throat. Honey, yes, dogs can eat honey. Honey is packed with countless nutrients such as vitamins A, B, C, D, E, and K, potassium, calcium, magnesium, copper, and antioxidants. Feeding dogs small amounts of honey can help with allergies because it introduces small amounts of pollen to their systems, building up immunity to allergens in your area. In addition to consuming honey, the sticky spread can also be used as a topical treatment for burns and superficial cuts. Milk, yes, dogs can have milk. But be cautious. Some dogs are lactose intolerant and don't digest milk well. While it is okay for dogs to have a little milk, owners should be cognizant of the symptoms of lactose intolerance and might want to stick to giving their dogs water. Peanut butter. Yes, peanut butter is okay for dogs. Peanut butter can be an excellent source of protein for dogs. It contains heart-healthy fats, vitamins B and E and niacin. Raw, unsalted peanut butter is the healthiest option. Read the label carefully to be sure the peanut butter does not contain xylitol, a sugar substitute that can be toxic to dogs. Popcorn, yes, dogs can eat popcorn. Unsalted, unbuttered, air-popped popcorn is okay for your dog in moderation. It contains riboflavin and thiamine, both of which promote eye health and digestion, as well as small amounts of iron and protein. Be sure to pop the kernels all the way before giving them to your dog, as unpopped kernels could become a choking hazard. Bread, yes, dogs can eat bread. Small amounts of plain bread, no spices and definitely no raisins, won't hurt your dog, but it also won't provide any health benefits either. It has no nutritional value and can really pack on the carbohydrates and calories, just like in people. Homemade breads are a better option than store-bought, as bread from the grocery store typically contains unnecessary preservatives, but it's best to avoid it altogether. Cashews, yes, dogs can eat cashews. Cashews are okay for dogs, but only a few at a time. They've got calcium, magnesium, antioxidants, and proteins, but while these nuts contain less fat than others, too many can lead to weight gain and other fat-related conditions. A few cashews make a nice treat, but only if they're unsalted. Yogurt, yes, yogurt is okay for dogs. Plain yogurt is a perfectly acceptable snack for dogs. However, some dogs may have trouble digesting dairy products. If your dog can digest it, the active bacteria in yogurt can help strengthen the digestive system with probiotics. Plain yogurt is the best choice. Avoid any yogurts with added sugar, and skip all yogurt with artificial sweeteners. Fish, yes, dogs can eat fish. Fish contains good fats and amino acids, giving your dog a nice health boost. Salmon and sardines are especially beneficial, salmon because it's loaded with vitamins and protein, and sardines because they have soft, digestible bones for extra calcium. With the exception of sardines, be sure to pick out all the tiny bones, which can be tedious but is definitely necessary. Never feed your dog uncooked or undercooked fish, only fully cooked and cooled, and limit your dog's fish intake to no more than twice a week. Ham, yes, dogs can eat ham. Ham is okay for dogs to eat, but certainly isn't the healthiest for them. Ham is high in sodium and fat, so while sharing a small piece is all right, it shouldn't be a continuous habit. Pork, yes, dogs can eat pork. Pork is a highly digestible protein, packed with amino acids, and it contains more calories per pound than other meats. Pork also may be less likely to cause an allergic reaction in some pets compared to other proteins. Salmon, yes, dogs can eat salmon. As mentioned above, fully cooked salmon is an excellent source of protein, good fats, and amino acids. It promotes joint and brain health and gives dog immune systems a nice boost. However, raw or undercooked salmon contains parasites that can make dogs very sick, causing vomiting, diarrhea, dehydration, and, in extreme cases, even death. Be sure to cook salmon all the way through. The FDA recommends at least 145 degrees Fahrenheit, and the parasites should cook out. Shrimp, yes, shrimp is okay for dogs. A few shrimp every now and then is fine for your dog, but only if they are fully cooked and the shell, including the tail, head, and legs, is removed completely. Shrimp are high in antioxidants, vitamin B12, and phosphorus, but also low in fat, calories, and carbohydrates. Tuna, yes, dogs can eat tuna, but only in small amounts. In moderation, cooked, fresh tuna is an excellent source of omega-3 fatty acids, which promotes heart and eye health. As for canned tuna, it contains small amounts of mercury and sodium, which should be avoided in excess. A little bit of canned tuna and tuna juice here and there is fine, prepared only in water, not oil, as long as it doesn't contain any spices. Wheat grains, yes, dogs can eat wheat and other grains. Dogs do not have to be grain-free, it is perfectly okay for them to have grains. In fact, grains like wheat and corn are great sources of protein, essential fatty acids, and fiber. If your dog has certain allergies, however, it might be best to avoid grains, but it truly depends on your dog. Ask your veterinarian for recommendations. Human foods dogs can't eat. Almonds, no, dogs shouldn't eat almonds. Almonds may not necessarily be toxic to dogs like macadamia nuts are, but they can block the esophagus or even tear the windpipe if not chewed completely. Salted almonds are especially dangerous because they can increase water retention, which is potentially fatal to dogs prone to heart disease. Chocolate, no, dogs should never eat chocolate. This isn't just an urban legend. Chocolate contains toxic substances called methylxanthines, which are stimulants that stop a dog's metabolic process. Even just a little bit of chocolate, especially dark chocolate, can cause diarrhea and vomiting. A large amount can cause seizures, irregular heart function, and even death. Do not have chocolate in an accessible location for your dog. If your dog does ingest chocolate, contact a veterinarian or pet poison helpline as soon as possible. Cinnamon, no, dogs shouldn't eat cinnamon. While cinnamon is not actually toxic to dogs, it's probably best to avoid it. Cinnamon and its oils can irritate the inside of dogs' mouths, making them uncomfortable and sick. It can lower a dog's blood sugar too much and can lead to diarrhea, vomiting, increased or decreased heart rate, and even liver disease. If they inhale it in powder form, cinnamon can cause difficulty breathing, coughing, and choking. Garlic, no, dogs shouldn't eat garlic. Like onions, leeks, and chives, garlic is part of the allium family, and it is 5 times more toxic to dogs than the rest of the allium plants. Garlic can create anemia in dogs, causing side effects such as pale gums, elevated heart rate, weakness, and collapse. Poisoning from garlic and onions may have delayed symptoms, so if you think your dog may have eaten some, monitor him or her for a few days, not just right after consumption. Ice cream. No, dogs shouldn't eat ice cream. As refreshing of a treat as ice cream is, it contains lots of sugar, so it is best not to share with your dog. Also, some dogs have an intolerance to lactose. To avoid the milk altogether, freeze chunks of strawberries, raspberries, apples, and pineapples to give to your dog as a sweet, icy treat. Macadamia nuts. No, dogs should never eat macadamia nuts. These are some of the most poisonous foods for dogs. Macadamia nuts, part of the Proteaceae family, can cause vomiting, increased body temperature, inability to walk, and lethargy. Even worse, they can affect the nervous system. Never feed your dog macadamia nuts. Incorporating veggies into your dog's diet. As you can see, there are so many benefits to adding vegetables into your dog's diet. And it's so easy to do. While you can, of course, buy fresh produce at your grocery store, frozen bags of veggies and canned goods work just as well. In fact, you can save a lot of time and money and reduce waste when you buy prepackaged products. A good tip is to also buy bags of blended veggies so your dog gets variety. However, before you start adding new things into your dog's diet, I want to encourage you to talk with your vet first. While it's generally safe to feed your pup vegetables, it's also good to get your vet's opinion on what veggies to feed your dog. Along with recommended portions so you don't accidentally overfeed your dog. A little note on meats. Vegetables are great for dogs, but please understand that dogs are carnivores that need meat and protein in their diet. In fact, they need more protein than humans do to thrive. While vegetables do contain protein, they don't contain nearly enough for a healthy dog diet. For example, carrots only provide 1 gram of protein per 100 grams. For optimal health, dogs need a diet that is between 18% and 30% protein. As a general guideline, the Association of American Feed Control Officials requires adult dog food to contain a minimum of 18% crude protein on a dry matter basis. So please add extra veggies into your dog's diet for optimal health, but understand that they can't live solely on vegetables. Before we wrap up, it's important to note that there are veggies that are not safe for dogs to consume. To help keep your dog safe, I've compiled a list of things below of some of the veggies that you should not feed your dog.